down the main street. As it passed the Hugh Godfroy clothing store, the Tiger was hit by a shell fired by an anti-tank gun, which wrecked one of the drive sprockets. Nevertheless, he still destroyed all the enemy vehicles in range and scattered the enemy unit. At this point, Wittmann himself takes up the story. I then decided to abandon the tank. We took all the weapons we could carry, but I didn't destroy the tank, as I believed that we could regain possession of it. I made my way to the next division, about 15 kilometers away. We had to dodge enemy tanks several times. Could have taken them out, but had no close-range anti-tank weapons. So with a heavy heart, we had to leave them be. I reached the division and immediately reported to it. The subsequent counter-attack destroyed the enemy and took the town. The bulk of the armored regiment and a rifle battalion were destroyed. Sepp Dietrich, his senior commander, later expressed his admiration in his report. Wittmann had made his way north on foot, approximately 15 kilometers to the headquarters of the Panzer Lehr Division. From there, he turned about with 15 Panzer IVs of the Panzer Lehr Division and once again headed for Villers-Bocage. Through his determined action, Wittmann and his Tiger tank destroyed the greater part of a powerful British offensive column, and acting solely on his own initiative and displaying the highest personal bravery, he averted a threat to the entire front of the 1st SS Panzer Corps. At that time, there were no reserves available to the Corps. With today's action, Wittmann has destroyed 138 enemy tanks and 132 anti-tank guns with his tank. Signed, Dietrich, SS Obergruppenführer Panzer General der Waffen SS.
Quite clearly, the engagement of Villers-Bocage was important. It prevented one of a series of British attempts to outflank the important communications centre and city of Caen from the west. However, to argue that Michael Wittmann, or indeed any other individual, could seriously have influenced the course of the campaign in the Normandy area is nonsensical. Quite clearly, no individual could have made a substantial difference to a campaign that was determined at much higher levels.
In response to this incredible feat, the highest tally of armor destroyed by a single tank in a single day's fighting, the Führer awarded the Knight's Cross of the Iron Cross with oak leaves and swords to SS Obersturmführer Michael Wittmann, commander of a heavy panzer company. Wittmann was the 71st soldier of the German armed forces to be so honored. Hitler knew the value of Wittmann as a national hero and pressed him to accept a post as a tank instructor where he could pass on his hard-won knowledge. Wittmann instead rejoined his battalion at the front. He felt he was needed there, and his deep-rooted sense of duty would not let him accept a cushy job. Wittmann knew that the war had entered its decisive phase. In spite of the material superiority of the enemy, which he had seen and experienced firsthand in Normandy, Wittmann was optimistic as he drove back to the front. He had only been able to spend a very short time with his young wife before he said goodbye and set out for Normandy. It was to be his last assignment. On August the 8th, 1944, Wittmann rode into his last battle. In an otherwise unremarkable encounter, his borrowed tank, bearing the number 007, was targeted by superior British forces. A direct hit blew the turret from the tank. Wittmann and his crew died instantly. The greatest tank hunter in the history of warfare was dead.
Michael Wittmann's credited with destroying 140 enemy tanks, and I'm afraid this comes under the scope of lies, damn lies and statistics. Whilst I wouldn't dispute that Wittmann scored a high number, it's fairly evident from events like Villers-Bocage, where he is credited with destroying 25 tanks. The recent evidence seems to suggest it was much nearer half a dozen to a dozen tanks and an awful lot of armoured personnel carriers, which have no effective defence or method of attack on on the Tiger. Relating why this came about, during the Russian campaign, an awful lot of cricket scores were run up by successful tank commanders. And under this guise, it was very good for the media at home, for publicity, in order to keep morale up at home. The Germans were very proficient at pushing forward their tank aces, also their aircraft aces. During the Russian campaign, though, frequently they're up against quite inferior equipment. The T-34 is seen as an excellent piece of equipment, but most of the kills would have been amongst the much thinner armed light tanks that would have had no response or no adequate protection from the Tiger and no way of destroying it.
Wittmann and his crew are buried at La Combe Military Cemetery in Normandy, near the site of his greatest victory at Villers-Bocage, a fitting resting place for a tireless warrior.
Mm-hmm.